back to my channel. If you're new here, thank you for tuning in. And if you like my videos, please do not forget to like, share and subscribe. And for those of you who are already a part of my YouTube family, thank you so very much. For those of you who have been following me on my Instagram account may already be aware that I was visiting Pondicherry the whole of last week. I was there and I was celebrating my 5th wedding anniversary, and from the thumbnail you are already aware that I am here to show you everything that I shopped from Pondicherry. So yes, this is a haul post, a haul video for Pondicherry. So I will be starting the haul video by showing you products in the event of which I actually bought it. So which means maybe telling a little bit of a story about the store or the studio or the place that I visited and what of course I bought. So starting first, I got something really, really nice to be given as gifts for, you know, my friends and my family. I am actually, so there are 10 of the same things that I bought, exactly the same pieces. So I'm not going to be opening all 10 of them, but I will open these to show you. So these are the fragrant candles, and as you can see, it actually has a leaf of a flower which is also present on these. I think it is really cute, and it also does look like, you know, not very little when you're giving it to someone as a souvenir, but at the same time it is not very heavy on the pocket. Now this was retailing at 120, and I got each of these for 100 rupees, and I got 10 of the same. So they're packed, two of these are packed, you know how this was, like a set of two was packed in one sheet of paper, and that is everything that I bought to give to my friends and family. This I actually bought from a shop, you know, like one of those that you have when you're walking down the street, which was very close to my hotel. We were staying at the Pala de Mahi. It is a mansion that has been converted into a boutique hotel, and it's really, really nicely done, so beautifully maintained. Loved the staff, the food, the feel. It was right on the rocky beach, and it is in the heart of the White Town, so it was an ideal place to stay because you were really in the middle of all the action. You didn't have to take a vehicle or anything for that matter to kind of go to one place, from one place to another. So this shop was actually on one of the, you know, the by lanes that we were crossing when we were just taking a stroll down the area, and I just, you know, stopped by and I liked it and I bought it. The next thing that I bought was, so I went to Anokhi. Now Anokhi is something that I before, or rather I would say I did, you know, I used to shop from Fab India, but not as much. Some of Fab India, the prints, the cuts, everything were too repetitive, and I thought the world had it, till such time I actually came across a shop or a brand called Anokhi, which most of you must be aware about. And I shopped from Anokhi for the very first time, I think back in 2012 or 13, something like that. Ever since then, I've been an ardent fan of their prints, their cuts, the fabric, everything. And when I saw Anokhi, again at a stone throw away distance from my hotel, I couldn't stop myself, because as you know, I am in Bangalore now. In Delhi it is far more accessible, but in Bangalore it is only in three places. One is the Leela Hotel, the other is I think the Rain Tree, which is again a boutique, and the third is somewhere in Jayanagar. All three of them, out of the three, two of them are very far for me, and one of them is less accessible because it's in the Leela Hotel. So if you are going to the hotel, you may go and shop, but who really wants to go inside a hotel? And you know, you want to be in your pajamas or something loose when you're shopping and not be all decked up, because then you're going to Leela Hotel at the same time, and then you will end up most likely having, you know, something at their coffee shop. So anyway, so long story short, so when I saw Anokhi, I could not stop myself. And if I'm not wrong, this is the first time I've shopped from a Nokia in 2.5 years because of being in Bangalore. So what all did I bring? So these days, one thing that I am really, really, really fond of is the dupattas in this fabric. Now this is, I think this is their cotton, they call it, the Kota silk. The Kota silk dupatta, and that's the fabric, and this is the print. Now this one I got in a green color, which has these beautiful pink berry flowers on it, leaves on it. And I thought it's really nice because you can again pair it up with something white. You can pair it up. I'm so sorry. I think that's the noise of the airplane. We also live close to the old airport in Bangalore, and now all these fighter planes keep going above my head. Okay, so this is one dupatta that I bought. I never bought this as a pair or as a set with a kurta and the lowers, but I did buy this just by itself because I thought I can pair it up with a lot of things. The other dupatta that I bought is this. I really love it. It's so sweet and pink, and I'm sure most of you would agree with me that this is such a lovely color. Again, you can pair it up with just anything. You can pair it up with something blue, with something pink, with something white, just plain black, and it will look so nice. So this was the second dupatta I bought. And the third dupatta, yeah, I know I went a little crazy on dupattas, even though I don't wear too many dupattas, but I thought it's always nice to have it because you know how it is, right? My phases in life, they keep changing. There comes a phase when I don't wear dupattas, then there comes a phase when I want to only wear dupattas. So yeah, so this is another one. This is a beautiful mint green with peachy pink flowers on it, and the material remains the same, which is Kota silk or Kota cotton for that matter. So it is these three dupattas. Now this and this is not similar at all. As you can see, they are very different from one another, and so does, you know, the look, and it will probably just change the way I will want to drape it, you know, when I drape it against the color that I'm planning to put against this. So it was these three dupattas I bought. Now each of these dupattas were at 1450 each, okay? So they were priced at 1450. I don't know if you can see this, but yeah, so they were priced at 1450 rupees each of them, and I think I am very happy to have bought all three of them. Then the next thing that I bought from Anokhi is a pair of straight pants. Now these you can also again mix and match with kurtas, with just short kurtis if you want to, if you don't want to wear it with a long kurta, or you can also wear a nice, you know, like the day I had gone to shop for Anokhi, I was wearing something that I actually put this, wore this in the bottom, and it did look nice. That was a proper top, you know, simple linen cotton top from H&M, and yeah, that also looked very nice with this. And then there was one set that I bought. So similar to that black, I bought that pink, I bought a black trouser, again black plain trouser. Now these again can be I wouldn't call them trouser, I would call them straight pants that you can, you know, very much pair with your kurtas, kurtis, or even for that matter with a top. Sorry for that. Okay, and each of these were priced at 1150. So I got two of these, and they were each for 1150. With the black pair of pants, I got this kurta. Now this is basically a cotton kurta, and I absolutely again loved it when I tried it. It had such a nice relaxed feel for the summer, and as you know, in Bangalore it just doesn't really get very hot, or it doesn't get very cold either. So this is, you know, clothes like these as something that I can really wear all around the year. And if of course if I am traveling to a place where it is hot, it is humid, then they are such a lifesaver. So lifesaver, sorry. So these are the clothes that I got from Anokhi. And then the next thing, I think a total I spent was about 9,050 or 9,450 rupees at Anokhi. Sorry, I can't find the bill. I've definitely misplaced it somewhere. Yeah, so that is how much I kind of spend at Anokhi. Also, there was one kurta that I had bought. I paid for it at their store in Pondicherry, but the size was not available. So the lady there was kind enough to call up at their Chennai store and arrange for a size and have it couriered to me from Chennai to my home in Bangalore. So I paid for it there, but I will get it probably in a day or two because we just returned from Pondicherry yesterday. Then the next thing that I did was, now we went to a place called Auroville. Now if you have been to Pondicherry, you would know that Auroville is the most popular tourist destination attraction in Pondicherry. And to tell you a little bit about Auroville, Auroville is basically, you know, it's a community started by people in the hope to make human unity and humanity the biggest and the greatest known worldwide. Now, it is basically a cashless economy. Yes, they do not encourage you to pay by cash, but of course you can use card or you can use, you know, your digital mode of payment like Google Pay, Paytm, etc. And everything that you have at Auroville is all made of recycled, whether it's paper, recyclable items, so paper, you know, even plastic, they don't buy or they don't use. That's why they give everything in paper bags like these. Like I got something from Auroville that was given to me in a paper bag like this. So this is there. And what I bought from there is basically this. So these are ceramic plates. Now they are slightly damaged. You can hardly tell how, you know, where they are damaged. I mean, I can't even tell where they are damaged from, frankly. Maybe if they are calling this as some kind of defect, I don't know. But for me, it really didn't matter. Not that it was very cheap or something. I mean, I did pay something like 450 rupees for this, but I thought it was really cute, and if I can contribute something to, you know, their way of life, then why not? So this is something that I bought. There are two plates that they have, I think, stuck, maybe using hot glue or aerolite, or I don't know what. So I wouldn't want to move this to many places in the house or use it for rough use, but rather you can keep some trinkets if you want. You can even place some candles, tea lights, whatever that you like, or maybe a fruit over it, whatever. But don't use it to keep something which is very, very heavy, and also don't move it around too much, because for all you know, it is only hot glued, it can also come off. So that was one, and the other that I bought was this. These are again two bowls, sorry, cups. One with a handle and one does not. And I thought this was so, so cute. Again, I bought it for just mere 450 rupees or 500 rupees, something like that. And this was really so cute. I thought you can again keep pens, you can keep accessories, you can keep some toiletries. You can just keep it like that in some corner, maybe pour some water in it and put a plant, like a money plant. It looks so cute. This is not very proper. Hopefully you can see it. The band that's going around it is not very proper, but that's fine. I thought to myself that, you know, once I'm back home, I can always take a twine, a rope, and just go around it and just do a little bit of a DIY, a 2-minute DIY, and it will change the overall look of this thing and will look really nice. So this was another thing that I bought. Again, like I said, it's multi-purpose. You can use it for so many things. All you need to do is not keep moving it around way too much, or don't keep anything too heavy and then try and lift it from here, because then of course chances are that this will come off. Again, this is only hot glued. I am very sure there's nothing else that they have done. They have just hot glued it. But again, because they are maybe damaged, but I don't know where are they damaged from, because I can't make out. If they are calling this, you know, then I don't know, because handmade pottery usually does have these, I won't call them defects. I mean, they are like, they're art again, right? I mean, they are, you know, ये निशानी होती है इस चीज की कि it's is handmade and it is, you know, handcrafted. So I think it's beautiful. And that was the second thing that I bought from Auroville. The third thing that I bought from Auroville is this. They are so cute, so cute. It is this. Look at this, guys. They're so sweet and so pretty and so festive. You can, you know, even put a tea light in it. Again, use it for keeping just accessories. Just keep it like that on your center table or wherever that you want to. And they will add so much of mood to that place. I bought it with the purpose of just that they're so cute and maybe I can just throw in some trinkets in it and keep it on my counter. Another thing is that they are again handmade, okay? So this is, I think it's paper and yeah, it's handmade paper which is crafted in this shape. And then I'm not too sure what is this material, but whatever that it is, it's looking so cute and pretty. These, I think I paid some 60 rupees each. So it was a pair that I got for 120. And then I went to a shop. So Auroville also has a shopping center. It's built very much inside the Auroville Vision Center. Auroville, by the way, is an area that is there in Tamil Nadu. It does not come under Pondicherry, but it does come as part of Tamil Nadu. So basically, you have to kind of drive down. If you're staying in Whitetown, then you have to drive down or maybe use a cab. We had our car, so we just drove down to this place. It was about 30 minutes from Whitetown and in the Vision Center, because that is where they have, you know, the Auroville life, stories about Auroville life, who are the people behind that community. And you get a little bit to know about, of course, everything that they are doing there. So we went there and this was a place in the shopping center. And I got these beautiful copper, I think it's copper, right? Or brass, not copper. Sorry, it's brass. So I got a set of these three plates from there. And again, you can use them for so many things. The bigger one is for, so this one was for 955 rupees. This one was for 774 rupees. And this one, the smallest one, was for 445 rupees. Now you can again use this for so many things. In fact, you can also use it if you want to serve, you know, some laddus, or you want to keep it to serve something else, you know, when somebody is coming over, especially during Diwali time. I really miss something like this, because in my house I don't have a lot of gold details, and so I don't have a lot of gold crockery also. But in fact, you know, someday I will probably want to give you guys a tour of my house, which has got a very farmhousey vibe. So everything that is there in my house is very, you know, non or unconventional stuff. So I think this was a good buy, because during Diwali time, I really miss something like this to put on my, you know, keep on my center table with some sweets on it. And when it's not Diwali, you can again use it as a decorative piece, or you can again keep it in your bathroom counter or on top of your dresser with whatever trinkets or small stuff that you want. So this is again that I bought from Auroville. And I am sorry, I bought four plates. I thought I bought three. No, there is a fourth one. Okay, there's a fourth one, and this is the bigger one, and this one was for 1400 rupees. Okay, so this one was for 1400. Then I had these three. So, sorry, this is the set actually. Yeah, there you go. Okay, so this is the set. You can use them as a set. You can, of course, keep them separately also, wherever that you wish to. Now, at or a will, something really interesting that I came across. Actually, I knew about it because before we went to Pondicherry, you know, I had seen a lot of videos from multiple YouTubers who travel and make, you know, who vlog only because they travel and they love to show people the places around. So I knew about this place. It's called Swaram. It is about giving the experience of music and musical instruments, and I have to say I absolutely fell in love with this. It is just, and they have packed it beautifully, by the way. I mean, this is the packaging that I got it in. This is when you open, there is a Velcro belt that secures the musical instrument. So there I open it, and there comes my piece. I absolutely loved this, guys. I think it is so pretty, and what's even better is this. Okay, wait till you hear the magic. Beautiful, na guys? It's so soothing and so calming to the ears. And as my name Rhythm, I have to say I finally found the rhythm of my life. This is so nice, and definitely was slightly expensive. This was for about 6,691, so almost 6,670. But I absolutely loved it. There were many more pieces in it. There were ones which were bigger in size, some which were smaller, but I thought this was good, ideal, and I imagined it to be on my console, and yeah, I think it's perfect for that place. So all in all, in Oroville, I spent about, I think I have the invoice. Yes, so I spent about 10,265 rupees at Oroville. And another thing that the lady at the Oroville shopping center, who was sitting at the billing counter, was sweet enough to give me a gift. She gave me actually something. Where did it go? Oh, here it is. Sorry. So she gave me something which is called the Pacholi hand rolled incense sticks, and there are just so many in it. It also comes with an incense stick holder. I'm really excited to burn these, and yeah, I mean, they're so nice to just put in the house morning, evening, any time of the day, and just, you know, make your house not only smell divine but also hush away any negative energy. So this is what I was gifted, and the rest of the stuff, as you know, I bought, and a total of 10,265 rupees is what I spent at Oroville. Okay, now let's go on to another place that I went to. It was called the Taboo Boutique. This was right next to a very famous dessert shop, a place called Bread and Chocolate. And this store was right next door. Beautiful looking store, lovely stuff, but I found them to be, you know, a little bit, you know, the clothes that were there, they looked really nice. In fact, I even tried on one or two things, but while they looked really nice on the mannequin, they didn't look very nice on me, or maybe that they weren't very wearable in normal day-to-day life. They are maybe something that you want to wear to a place where people understand those kind of clothes, right? So something that I thought was great, but only to see, for great for the eyes, but not really great to wear. But I again really did want to pick up something from there, and I picked up this cute little basket which was for about 529 rupees, and not very expensive. I thought, my husband definitely thought that it was a little too expensive for something like this, but you know, they don't really go to stores and see things around. I do, and or we women do, so we have an idea of how much would you want to pay for a basket like this, which is, you know, painted, has a quirky color. It's cane, and cane, as you know, is slightly expensive. So this is something that I got. There were different sizes in it, and I got this size because this again was something that I thought can be used to keep in, you know, you can just roll in some towels and want to put it in a bathroom counter. Just put in some stuff and put it on your study table. Use it as you like, because these things have a lot of multi-usage and you can use them for so many things. Just having baskets around the house, I think, is really nice because it really helps to keep things more organized and it looks nice. You can hide a lot of clutter. So that was from there. And I also bought a shirt, which if you are following me on my Instagram account, you would have seen me wearing it because I did post also about it. Nahi dekha hai toh please, you know, you can just go to my Instagram account. I will link it in the video and you can take a look at it. It's a beautiful cotton red, you know, it's not checks, but there's small triangles made on it, and it's a knotted shirt, and it was so comfortable to wear it. Right now it's in the washing and I don't have it here with me, but otherwise I would have loved to see show it to you here. Like I said, you can always go back to my Instagram account and see me wearing it. I had paired it with a loose harem linen cotton pajama from H&M. You can, of course, you know, as you like, you can pair it up with a pair of jeans, skirt, or, you know, trousers, pants, anything that you like. It's a knotted one. I think it was damn stylish. The best part was I didn't try it. I just bought it. By looking at it, I thought it's gonna look really nice on me, and I bought it, and thank God to my luck that it did fit me perfectly well. It was also not very expensive. It was hardly some 776 rupees that I paid for that, and I thought it was a really, really good buy, especially for the summers or places where it's humid and sticky. That fabric, you know, was a dream. It made me feel so comfortable on a day in Pondicherry, which was so humid and sticky, and all we wanted to do was go in and out of the pool in the hotel because it was so sticky. So I actually wore that top later in the day, and it, like, you know, like I said, was really nice. Okay, on the same day, I'm so sorry, there is one black, not black, sorry, there's one fly in the house, a house fly, of course. So she or he will be in the house, but I don't know why is it so interested in coming in my video right now, but theek hai. We had gone to Golden Bridge Pottery. Now, unfortunately, Golden Bridge Pottery was closed on at least the day when I went to that place. And the other days I kept calling them, but they wouldn't answer. So I'm not sure if they have permanently closed down, were they just closed for those couple of 3 to 4 days, or what was it like. But it was not open. Golden Bridge Pottery is also the most famous place for pottery, to learn pottery also in Tamil Nadu, in Pondicherry. It is a place that also sells a lot of ceramic. Now, I definitely wanted to go and see it, but to my hard luck, I was not able to. So I looked up the net while we were there, and we came across also an Insta page called Clay and Glaze. This is run by a beautiful family who I happen to also meet. Again, if you are on my Instagram, you may have seen me put up a story. She actually was sweet enough to welcome me into her house, beautiful house, and I think that was also very nice because I got to experience how houses are like in Tamil Nadu. So I went to her place, and she is running you know, a page also on Instagram called Clay and Gaze. This is what the page is. Her name is Anamika Sarogi. Very, very warm lady. Beautiful smile, I must say. If you're watching me, Anamika, then please accept my compliments, because I know I didn't say this to you then, but I kept thinking in my mind, okay, I'm gonna say this. I don't know how it just slipped out of my mind because we just got talking so much. And of course, I bought a lot of pottery from Anamika. So she also, by the way, has learned her you know, art from Golden Bridge Pottery. And the first thing that I bought from there was this. This is a very nice, beautiful, I mean, look at the color, look at the shape. It's so nice. It's, you can use it to, you know, it's poorer. You can use it to even put some plant, you can use it to just keep it on your center table or on your dining table, wherever that you wish to. I thought this was really, really cute, and for some reason I'm really fascinated by jugs and this, you know, this whole shape of creamers and pourers. So this was one thing that I bought from her. The other thing that I got from her is, the other thing I bought from her is this oil pourer. Now, again, if you like, you can also put, you know, if you're into a lot of spaghettis or Italian food and you want to keep something like this on the center, on your dining table when you are eating, then this is really handy. She also gave me these two corks that you can put in this, and this I have bought it to keep it in my kitchen on the countertop. I want to basically pour oil in it and use it for, you know, cooking purpose. But yeah, this is something that I got from her again. I can't really remember how much each one of these were, but I do know how much I ended up paying her in total. But if I'm not wrong, this was around 700 something and this was around 800 something. Yeah, so this is again that. So I got this from her again. You can use this for decoration, you can use this for serving. I of course have bought it for serving you know, snacks or any other thing when I have guests over. So this was another thing that I bought from her. This also, if I'm not wrong, was for about thousand something, if I'm not wrong. But again, please pardon me if I am saying the wrong prices. Yeah, mere hisab se better rahega if you just go on to their page on Insta and check out what the individual prices are. Like I said, I'll be able to share with you what I paid in total to her, but I can't remember what the individual prices were because there is no price tag, and she, you know, kept telling me when I asked her, and I don't know. So this is another thing that I bought. It's a creamer, these two I thought can be used again for many, many uses, many, many ways you can use them. And ye to matlab is, you know, a sauce pourer or a creamer that you can use it for. Another creamer that I bought from her, I don't know why did I buy so many creamers, but actually I just bought them because they were so cute. I mean, I love the shape, I love their colors, and they were so beautiful, and the lady herself was so enthusiastic in showing me her stuff. I really just kept saying yes, 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 yes to almost everything that I was seeing. Look at this, guys. Isn't it so cute? I mean, this is really a lovely piece of art. It has no color paint here. It is really the stone, and this part of it is being colored. So sorry if I'm not using the right terminology. Of course, I don't know what exactly is. All I know is it's ceramic and it's beautiful, and I wanted to get it, so I bought it. So yes, so it was these things that I bought. Oops. Oh, where did the plate go? Yeah. So it was these things that I bought from Clay and Glazed Pottery. It was these four things that I got from her. And again, you can please visit her page on Instagram. She does ship worldwide, not only in India, but they also ship it outside of the country, and they ensure that the pieces are not broken. Of course, if there is any damage, I'm assuming you have to, you know, maybe film a video, like most of these people these days advise you to do with things that are breakable or that can be damaged in the transit process. It's best that you film a video while you're opening it, so that they know that you received it like that and not that it got damaged after you received it during whatever time. So they do pack it like this in boxes like these, and like this was a box, you know, in which she had put this. And she, of course, she knew I was only, you know, going to be traveling in the car with it, so maybe she didn't bother putting too much of bubble wrap, which I understand why to unnecessarily waste also, because it was going to come to me in the car very safely, and yes, it had all reached very safely with me. So all in all, at her place, I think I spent around 2,930 rupees, which includes all of these. And she also was so sweet that she gave me a gift. So this is a gift from Anamika to me. I'm going to open it. I love the way she had packaged it. Imagine, so sweetly she put a bow and all on it. Oh my God, why are people so sweet in this world? Okay, and this is a beautiful pot that she gifted me. A pot hai, toh obviously you will put plants in it. But yeah, I mean, I thought it was so sweet of her. I love the color. It's got this, you know, what would you call this now? Some style or, you know, that diamond glow effect. So it's really, really sweet of her to have gifted this to me. And I absolutely love the color. I have a lot of blue in my house. So it again is something that is going to go very well with the rest of my house. So yes, I think that's really it. Have I shown you everything that I've bought? I think yes. So yes guys, this is everything that I bought from Pondicherry. A total of... Oh no, I have to show you this. Oh my God, how did I forget to show you this? This is the most expensive gift that I bought for myself from this place called Chin's. Beautiful store, again at a stone throw away distance from my hotel, which is why it was very dangerous, because I kept going back and seeing what other stuff can I buy. So Chin's is something like Ogaan. So it's a multi designer retailer brand, and it has not only does it have outfits like clothes, it also has accessories, it also has some home decor stuff, bedding, etc. So it was a beautiful store, and I bought from there some pieces of accessories. Now they did have accessories there also from Amrapali and it also did have things from their local designers. Now the only thing was, there were some things that I saw there that were there from their local designers. Beautiful pieces, I must say. My God, they were gorgeous, and I really did want to pick up something also, but I was not too sure if I should, because you know, they said it was cut diamond. It was, I think it was a pair of earrings for about 24,000 rupees. But if it's cut diamond, 24,000 rupees, okay, sure, all said and done. But when you're buying something like that, then you expect some kind of certificate, some kind of authenticity, you know, to ensure that you're, because you're spending 24,000 rupees, it's also not very small, it's not 10 less, you know. But when you're spending that much, then you definitely want to make sure that you are spending on something which has or comes with a certificate or something to show its authenticity, which was missing. And so I did not get that. Otherwise, I really was interested in buying those earrings. They were gorgeous. Anyway, so what I did buy from them was all actually that was under Amrapali, the brand, because that brand I trust with eyes closed. Most of you, I'm sure, know about that brand. It has got beautiful stuff, and I got these earrings from them. So these are a pair of silver earrings, silver gold plated earrings. It is, let me actually show you like this. So this is what the earring looks like. It has these three leaf flowers, and they look absolutely gorgeous. I thought I could pair it up with just so many things, especially when, you know, you are wearing something Indian, or this is something which will even go with something Western. So I, in fact, ye main soch rahi thi, main, you know, I can wear it and show it to you guys so that you see how it looks. There guys, so abhi shayad aapko itna nahi samajh aa raha ho, because of course I'm wearing a sweatshirt, or I mean a hoodie, so maybe it's not going very well with it for obvious reasons. But I think it will look so beautiful and so nice, even if you are wearing a nice, you know, long sweet sleigh dress, or if you're wearing, of course, something that is Indian, earrings like these will never, ever, ever regret your buy. So this was one pair of earrings that I bought from there. And the other pair of earrings, so this pair of earring was for about, okay, so this was priced at 3899. Is it focusing, not focusing? Wo samajh nahi aa raha hai. I'm not sure, guys, but anyway, this was priced at rupees 3899, and then the other pair of earrings that I bought were these. Now these are again pure silver earrings. Very nice, different design, I must say. I've never seen something like this before. I mean, generally main silvers mein ya to ekdam, you know, those drops that you see, or jhumki style, or but this was very quirky, and at the same time, my god, they are so beautiful. You can again wear this both Indian, Western, you know, with this, imagine wearing something like this with this pair of anything that you buy, in fact, from a Nokia. Like, you know, such things, they go like, look at this. Suddenly it's, you know, looking so different and it's looking so nice. I absolutely love the design. They are light, they're not very heavy, and they were priced at rupees, sorry guys if you can hear a bit of drilling sound, but hamare yahan pe na construction kabhi khatam hoti hi nahi hai. Matlab people like to keep revamping their house, I feel, because kuch na kuch chalta hi rehta hai. Anyway, these were priced at rupees 3199. Again, I'm not too sure if you can see it, if it's clear, if it's focusing, but yeah, this is something that I bought from the same place. And now comes the third pair of earrings, and they have to be my most favorite pair of earrings. Let me show this to you first. Isn't it beautiful? Aren't they simply so gorgeous? Again, they are also from Amrapali. They are for majorly to be worn with Indian outfits, or of course if you want to, you know, style it differently, you can of course wear it with something like a nice long dress also. And they are gorgeous, guys. Look at the detailing, the blue stones, these pearl drops here, and of course this whole gold you know, style. And I absolutely fell in love with them the first time I saw it. They were really my love at first sight. Pehli baar mein maine isko dekhte hi bola, I told the lady there, can you please help me try these. I tried it on and I told her I am definitely getting this. Matlab no two ways about it. They were so beautiful. They are so beautiful that there was no way I was going to give it a miss for anything. So this was for 7,050 rupees. Now again, they are silver with gold plated, and they are by Amrapali. So all together, how much did I spend? Yeah, so altogether I spent about 14,148 rupees at the store called Chintz. And this was something that I think after Anokhi, no, so okay, so everywhere. So here I paid 14,148. Then at Auroville I had spent about 10,265, plus that shirt, which is not part of this bill because that was at another shop in the same you know, in the vicinity. And then at Anokhi I spent about 9,000 something. So yeah, so I think, and then yahan se idhar udhar, you know, little bit here, little bit there, aise karte karte, I think I must have overall spent about anything between 35 to 40,000 rupees on my shopping in Pondicherry, but I thought everything was so worth it. And I am a shopaholic. I love shopping. I know it's a disease. I'll be honest, it's a disease that I have. Nahi hota mujhse control, you know, how much ever you try, I just cannot control shopping. And if I like something, then I have to get it. Ya to hona ki wo cheez mujhe pasand nahi hai, to fir yes, of course I will not buy it just for the heck of it, no. But if I like it, then there is no two ways that I'm going to leave it behind. So I have bought everything from Pondicherry while I was there. We were there for about 5 days and 4 nights. And had an absolutely wonderful time. I would definitely recommend you to go visit Pondicherry if you haven't already. It is a really nice coastal place, on the lines of Goa, but less touristy. Beautiful cafes. As you know, it is the French capital of India, and it is a place I would want to go back to again and again and again. I don't think Goa, maybe mere, you know, has never like the place Goa never grew onto me like the way Pondicherry did. So yeah, that definitely has to be one of the places that I will want to go back to. And all the shopping that I have done, you don't have to only go and spend so much. You can go to Anokhi, buy one thing. You can go to Auroville, buy one thing. There were, you know, less expensive options also. It just so happened that the things that I was liking happened to be, the things that I was liking happened to be a little bit, you know, on the expensive side. But theek hai, I think itna to banta hai. It was my 5th wedding anniversary and I definitely wanted to go, you know, all out there. So thank you for watching, guys. I hope you really liked this video. If you did, please don't forget to like, share and subscribe my video. And hoping to see you very, very soon in my next video. I have bought a lot of other stuff from a few other places which you will very well, you know, which you will get to know in the videos to come. So stay tuned. So yes, thank you for watching. Bye.